Welcome to the world's best metal detecting videos. Fantastic videos for everybody. Junk of that. Looks like there's been some digging here. Around this area. The video is, the new recording system is, I switch it on, I record throughout the hunt, and at the end of the hunt, it's then switched off, so there's no editing anymore. It's just one continuous filming, whatever you call it, filming shoot. Take one and that's it. It's like, it's taking too much time. Keep switching the camera off and on for every dig. So it will be continuous, start to finish. Very spitty that 85. This is I'm guessing a steel bottle top. That's not on the surface, is that? You try and come to me, man. Switch it back to that one. Frequency max 24 kilohertz. VDI 94. I've really not got a lot to say on my videos. I just like to dig. Detect and dig and not talk too much, because most of them are just talking a lot, swaffling a load of, you know, cod's wallet, whatever you want to call it, that metal detectors, and all the different theories that they've got. This is a drinks tin. That's one theory that I've got, is that 94 on the surface. Recently lost Tupi coin. Yeah, that new Mine Lab Pro Find 40 Ferristone ID. 10% extra depth. And all the usual features, vibrating and everything else. Lamp, LED light on it. The only problem with the XPMi4, in my opinion, it does lack a little bit of depth on it. Could just be, if it were just a little bit deeper. But I'm not on YouTube for views. That's just some more cancel that. No, I'm not on YouTube for views. There is a certain detectorist on YouTube, especially the one in New York. A guy in New York is posting videos up just to get to views, probably. He's posting some useful information, but his videos are all aimed at getting views and thumbs up. Mine's not like that. Mine are just, it's just done for something to do, like pass some time. I-52. I really don't care if only 10 people watch this video. I'm not bothered. There's no likes. The videos will still be going up on YouTube. But it's a coin that it's just a 5p Cupro nickel. Mid-50s VDI. 56. Last 56. It was a 5p. Is anybody listening? But, this is looking like it's some more of that horrible cancer. Oh, yeah, I've just missed it. It's alright, it's another 5p that. Second one, BDI 55. Like, I don't like this recovery speed, 2.5. It seems to just have the right amount of speed. Another signaller. 63. That's not a coin number, that, on this field. This is probably a pull tab. I don't know all the coin numbers actually. And this is not a coin number. It's just some cancellor. Square tab. Just on the surface. Is a pull tab probably. Oh, I think this might be a steel bottle top. It sounds very sputtery. Cancel off. A big piece at depth. Fifty six. Well, I have not found a gold ring this year. In fact, I found hardly any rings at all. One gold-plated ring. No silver rings. Despite digging thousands of holes, there's no luck. That's just crap, that. I missed that. Well, it's not a bad, it's too deep. That's a fucking drinks tin, that. $87. Sounds small. It could be a chubby. But otherwise, known as a pound coin. And it is. Yeah, it's a new shaped £1 coin. Another 20 minutes here, and this hunt is finished. Well, it seems small. And the pinpoint is not picking it up. It is actually probably junk, this. Yeah. the deep junk. It's all right. Tab area. Oh, it's here in America. That would be a nickel actually. But that's just a Cupra nickel 10p that. I thought that might have been a tab. $65 for that 10p coin. Almost certainly a £1 coin. Just on the surface. You can bet your last dollar. It is a £1 coin. Oh, I can feel it. That's a nice one, look. Nice and shiny. Just looks like a gold coin. Gold ring or not, I'm leaving it. It is deep, that. Not worth taking it. Whatever it is, I'm not really bothered. $64, $65. The last $65 was a 10p. Oh, this is a tab. Well, I have tried detecting this field for about 2 weeks, 3 weeks possibly, and well, no gold off it, no gold rings. for watching the video. I am now switching off.